configuration. Now we are discussing about the output characteristics of a transistor. What are these output characteristics of a transistor? Whenever we are connecting the transistor in the common emitter configuration, we are giving the input to the base terminal. That means we are taking the output from the collector terminal because we have made the emitter terminal common. So we are taking the correct output from the collector terminal. Output means we can take either current that is IC because we are taking the output current, or we can take the voltage that is VCE. So the output characteristics I am drawing here are the VI characteristics which are drawn of VCE on the X axis because the voltage I am taking at the collector terminal with respect to the base. Sorry, with respect to the emitter. So I am taking the VCE on X axis. In reality, I am taking the output voltage at the collector terminal, but with respect to emitter, I am taking so VCE on the X axis and on the Y axis, IC, the collector current. Initially, I have taken the base current IB is equal to 100 microamperes. We have fixed the base current. How we can fix a base current? Are we giving the current? Do we have any current source? No, we do not have any current source. But we are applying the battery. How with the battery we can manage the 100 microamperes? By changing this battery voltage, by changing that VBB, the current that we are giving to the transistor base can be controlled. So we are adjusting the battery knob VBB in such a way that the base current is 100 microamperes. Now the base current is 100 microamperes, we have fixed it. Now we are not bothering about this input circuit that we have already seen in the input characteristics of a transistor when it is connected in the common emitter configuration. Now we are changing this VCC. The VCC we are changing, whenever we are changing the VCC, the collector current is incrementing. When we are changing the VCC, this transistor is connected in the reverse bias. This transistor is connected in reverse bias, we are incrementing the collector voltage. The reverse bias current should not be affected with respect to the applied voltage. But here, when we are incrementing the VCC, the reverse bias current is getting affected. How? Because of one factor, when we are incrementing this VCC, because of that depletion region width is incrementing. Why the depletion region width is incrementing? Because this is connected in reverse bias. So this depletion region width is not incrementing uniformly. Why it is not incrementing uniformly? Because this region collector is heavily doped with respect to the base region. Base is lightly doped and the collector is heavily doped. So this depletion region spread is more towards the base. That means the depletion region spread is less towards the collector. Because the depletion region is spreading more towards the base region width is decrementing. Because this base region width is decrementing, the number of carriers in the base region that are getting recombined are becoming very less. So because the number of the carriers are becoming very less, the number of carriers, the majority carriers that are in the emitter, which are to be recombined in the base, are decrementing. So majority carriers are moving towards the collector because the base region is very small now. So the remaining all carriers which are recombining previously, now all those carriers are moving towards the collector. That is the reason for the increment of the collector current. We are incrementing the VCC. Because of this increment of the VCC, depletion region width is changing. That depletion region width, change of the depletion region width is not uniform in the base and the collector. That depletion region width is more, the spread is more in the base. Because of that, the base width is very less. Because of that, the number of carriers that are reaching from the emitter to the collector are incrementing. Until which point this will happen? Until a certain point. We are incrementing the VCC. Because of that, what we are calling as VCE is incrementing. until a certain point, the collector current gets incremented. After a certain point, even though we increment the voltage VCE, the collector current almost remains constant. Why I am saying almost remains constant? Because practically, even though I am drawing this graph in a straight linear manner, practically you can observe a straight, not almost a little bit increment. Why this is happening? Because after that certain point, even though we are incrementing, why the current is remaining constant? First, we will discuss about that point. After a certain point, the majority carriers that are moving from the emitter to the collector, they are not changing. They have become constant. Means emitter is saying, I am not ready to give one extra electron because I have only these electrons only. So I can say, I am sending already the maximum electrons. So I cannot increase the current. The emitter is saying, okay, so the collector current remained constant. This constant at the maximum collector current. Now why? Second question. Why this increment is observed? Because of one factor. This base, what we are calling, the base width is decrementing. So there is no change in the number of electrons that are moving from the emitter to the collector. But only change is, they are not getting recombined in the base. Instead of recombining in the base, they are directly moving to the collector. That's why there is a small increment in the collector current. So this region, whatever I have shown to you with the stars, this is called as saturation region. And this region where the collector current remains constant, this is called as active region, almost constant. So in this active region, even though we are incrementing the voltage, the current is almost constant. So transistor can be used as amplifier. The transistor in the saturation region can be used as an amplifier? No, because it does not have the ability to amplify the signal. But the transistor in this active region, when we are even though incrementing the voltage, the current is almost remained constant. This region is called as active region. And after that, still we are trying to increment the voltage VCE. And when we are incrementing the voltage, the depletion region will be spreading more towards the base. And it will spread in such a way that the depletion region at one time will reach the emitter. This point we call as reach through. So whenever we are saying the reach through, at the point of the reach through, already base is vanished. No point to say the base is existing at that point. What we are calling as a reach through. So reach through is a point when we are incrementing the VCC, the depletion region width is incrementing in the base, the depletion region spreading more in the base, and at one point of time the depletion region width, the depletion region reaches the emitter. So because the depletion region is reaching the emitter, this point we are calling as reach through. So at that reach through, at that point of reach through, still the collector current is constant and maximum. Even we are trying to increment the VCE, when we are trying to increment the VCE still, then instead of the depletion region spreading more towards the emitter, this will start spreading towards the collector. Why? Why suddenly it reversed its nature? Because the emitter is heavily doped and the collector is lightly doped. Until now, collector is heavily doped compared to the base. That's why the depletion region is spreading more towards the base. Now the emitter is heavily doped with respect to the collector, so the depletion region is spreading more towards the collector. And when we are incrementing this voltage, this depletion region starts spreading towards the collector, and what at one point of time this depletion region touches the collector's last electrode. So at that voltage, the transistor loses its properties and a tremendous amount of current will be incremented. Then the transistor does not behave like a transistor. That particular voltage at which this phenomenon occurs is called as punch through. So we have discussed about two phenomena. One is reach through, second one is punch through. In a reach through, the depletion region is reaching the emitter. It is reach through. In punch through, the depletion region is reaching the emitter collector's electrode. It is punch through. Now, the same phenomenon, if we are giving the base current 60 microamperes, sir, how can we decrement the base current from 100 microampere to 60 microamperes? If it happens by decrementing the base voltage. When we are decrementing the base voltage, the base current decrements. When the base current decrements, the same experiment when we are repeating, the same thing will be repeated. So if we give the base current as 0 microamperes and when we try to do this experiment, the transistor at that time it is in the cutoff region. So three regions we have discussed. One is cutoff region. In that cutoff region, the transistor emitter junction is reverse biased and the collector junction is also reverse biased. Second one is saturation region. In that saturation region, the emitter junction is forward biased and the collector junction, emitter junction, emitter base junction is forward biased. And the collector base junction is also forward biased. So it is acting in the saturation region. In the active region, the emitter junction is forward biased and the collector junction is reverse biased. Now we will see, now we will observe. If I give this voltage, VCC, some 9 volts, base voltage some 0.7 volts. Now, you can observe two diodes here. Why I am drawing the diodes like this? Because this is an NPN transistor, this is a P-terminal. Now this diode, I have, this is a PN diode, positive terminal, and then negative terminal, anode, cathode, I have connected to the positive terminal of the battery. Now, I have connected the anode to the positive terminal of the battery, cathode to the negative terminal. Now it is behaving like, it is operating in forward bias. So this diode is forward bias, but here, at the anode terminal, the voltage is 0.7 volts positive. At the cathode terminal, the voltage is 9 volts, still it is positive. But this diode is reverse biased. So why it is reverse biased? Here there is no negative voltage. Even though there is no negative voltage, the voltage of the cathode is more compared to the voltage of the anode. So that's why this diode is being operated in the reverse bias. So this is forward bias, this is reverse bias. Instead of that, we will do some one change. Instead of 9 volts, I have somehow I managed with the RPS and I changed it to some 0.01 or some 0.1 and I am giving here some 1 volt. Okay, now observe here. This is 1 volt, this is 0 volts, this is forward bias. This is 1 volt, this is 0.1 volt, this is also forward bias. At the anode 1 volt, at the cathode 0.1 volts. At the anode 1 volt, at the cathode 0 volts. This is forward bias and this is also forward bias. So from this graph we can observe the output characteristics of a transistor when it is connected in the common emitter configuration. The saturation region can be occurred for the smaller voltages of VCE. So when we give the smaller voltages at the collector, when we are getting the smaller voltages at the collector of the transistor, then this transistor output characteristics, what we are seeing at the smaller voltages of VCE, we call those characteristics as saturation region characteristics. Now we have changed the voltage at the base to the 0 volts. When we are giving the 0 volts at the base terminal, then there is no current to the transistor IP base. So IP is 0, then this is reverse bias and it is also reverse bias. This is reverse bias and I am giving here 9 volts. This is reverse bias, so the transistor is being operated in the cutoff region. So these three regions I am discussing, these three regions can be discussed with the help of the output characteristics of a transistor in the common emitter configuration. In cutoff region, the both the junctions can be reverse biased. In the saturation region, the both the junctions are forward biased. In the active region, the emitter junction is forward biased and the collector junction will be